let's go quickly over to Daryl Nail, who has a special guest at the Operations and Support Building.
That's right, Stephanie. I'm on the fifth floor of that building, which gives us an elevated view of the launch pad. And you can see, we can see the rocket from top to bottom, including the flame trench. It is a beautiful view out here. And then we stretch out a little further, and you can see the guests that have gathered in the infield. They have quite a view as well. This building is also right next to the iconic Vehicle Assembly Building, which is the perfect backdrop for our guest, as you mentioned, Administrator Jim Bridenstine. Thank you for being here. Appreciate your time.
Thanks, Daryl. Great to be here.
First of all, tell me what this launch means to you. What does it mean to the country?
So this is the first time we're going to launch American astronauts on American rockets from American soil, the first time since the retirement of the space shuttles in 2011. So this is really a significant achievement in the history of American spaceflight. And what we're interested in, we want to make sure that we keep our partnership with Russia, which has been very strong for a long period of time, going all the way back to the Apollo-Soyuz era. But we also want to make sure we have our own capability to get back and forth to the International Space Station so that we can have this strong partnership where they can launch on our rockets and we can launch on their rockets. But I think another big milestone here is the idea that we're not, as an agency, as NASA, we're not purchasing, owning, and operating our own rockets at this point. We're looking to a future where we can be a customer, one customer of many customers in a very robust commercial marketplace in low Earth orbit. And not just one customer of many customers, which drives down our costs and increases our access, but having multiple providers that are competing on cost and innovation, which enables us to have transformational technologies that enable us to do more than ever before. So this is really a big deal.
And one of those customers, key customers, SpaceX, which is launching tonight. You're here for that launch. You got to tour around today with SpaceX CEO Elon Musk. How was that?
It was a great opportunity. He reminded me that he began this process 18 years ago, if you can imagine that, back in 2001. And at the time, you know, the intent was to put a little greenhouse on Mars, and he was going to purchase an excess ICBM from Russia. Mm-hmm. Of course, he made sure to make clear that it was without the nuclear warhead. but what was fascinating is from that idea where he wanted to put on Mars a little greenhouse, we're talking about 3 feet by 3 feet, just a small greenhouse. And from that, he tried to buy this excess ICBM, but it was $20 million. And he said, look, I just can't afford that to achieve what I'm trying to achieve. And so he came up with the idea of a Falcon 1. And after a number of failed launches, he stuck with it. And by Falcon 4, it was successful. And then, of course, the partnership with NASA and a long partnership that's been developing for a long time. And here we are on the precipice of returning to spaceflight from American soil. So it was great to have that opportunity to hear his perspectives. And this is really a big day for NASA. It's a big day for SpaceX, Elon Musk, and the entire team, both teams, NASA and SpaceX.
And we're looking forward to a launch tonight. We appreciate you coming out and joining us. It's going to be an exciting night. We want to toss it back now to Tom, who is at SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California. Tom?